Hello friends, Chris here again with another training tip. A few days ago I told you about the front squat and how to improve it without just doing more and more and more and more weight, because sometimes if you've got a little bit of a wonky back like I do, it can get frustrating. It's not always very effective. So one thing you can do is do a little bit less weight, but make the movement harder by pausing. That was a very effective tip. I think some people got a kick out of that. We've got another one for the deadlift. So how do you deadlift or pull more weight? Either an Olympic style where your butt's down, your back's a little straighter, and your chest is up a little higher, or a powerlifting style where traditionally your butt's a little higher and you're going for a different movement, but still pulling heavy. The first thing you can do was step one, getting in shape to deadlift and to pull a lot of weight, right? So you get strong abs with abdominal exercises. You do like back raises and glute ham raises to get your butt and your hamstrings in shape, right? You do grip work so you can hold that bar. Like Zach Evanesh does a lot of, with young athletes, a lot of farmers carries and stuff. It's tremendous for just holding weight and developing yourself and getting ready to do things like deadlift. Where do you go from there? Well, the next step will be just repetition work with a barbell, right? So you start with a little bit of weight for 3 reps, 5 reps, and you add what you can when you can, usually weekly, and you feel really good for a long time until you get strong enough to where you start having trouble recovering from all that work. If you can deadlift 200 pounds, 300 pounds, and 400 pounds, it's okay. If you get close to 500, it comes at a better cost. So you got to start kind of adding variety. What can you do then? A great place to go first, speed reps. So backing the weight down and pulling the weight faster, always effective. You can do then special exercise. So once you get really good at deadlifting, you can do things like partial deadlifts. So the weight is elevated off the ground, either on boxes or pins or whatever. So you're pulling it heavier, shorter range of motion, or you can do things like deficit deadlifts, or like Klokov deadlifts, my favorite, where you can stand on a platform, maybe you deadlift with straight legs. So you're doing variations of the lift, very heavy to sort of fine-tune your nervous system and to add a little variety. But even that can get a little boring. Where do you go from there? Well, I've learned one thing. I give credit to Chad Vaughn, who's been crushing this lift on Instagram, doing tempo deadlifts. Now, what does that mean? Something new to know, right? Basically, it just means you're going to have the bar in your hands for longer with a little bit less weight, but making it really, really hard. At least that's my interpretation of it. So what do you do with this? I got a video to show you of me being crushed by these things a couple nights ago in my garage. But the idea is you're just going to hold the bar longer. Just like when you front squat and you do pauses, it's on you longer. Just like if you're working your snatch position, if your shoulders need to be improved health-wise, what do? Well, you can snatch it, and one of the easiest ways to get better is to hold it above your head for a while. Don't be so in a mad rush to drop it. Deadlift works the same way. So how would you do these deadlifts? Well, one thing is pick it up like normal, get it to the top, squeeze that bar, and just breathe. 1, 2, hold it in your hands. And you're going to notice that whereas before you pick that thing up and just drop it, it's pretty easy to handle a lot of weight. If you hold on to that weight for a while, your back's going to start really having to work to stay in position. And then the kicker, the real kicker, you lower that thing under control. You could do it 3 seconds. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3. You can do it for 5. I think in this video I do 4 or 5. Basically lowering it down nice and smooth. And that is really, really hard. What does that do? More time under the weight, sure. But also it takes advantage of that eccentric portion. So when you lower the weights and you're lengthening muscles, you have a huge ability to generate force and to accumulate work in that way. But you can get really strong because usually you just drop that weight. That's a common thing you see CrossFitters do. They pick it up and they drop it. Powerlifters, when I powerlifted it, I picked it up, I dropped it. If you just lower it down under control, you can get a really good amount of work done with not a lot of weight. And that's what it's all about, making more with less. The easy way to get strong and beat yourself up less. So what I want to show you now, quick set of me doing 4 or 5 reps in this way. Not a lot of weight, but you can see on my face just how hard this shit is. I recommend you try it. What you want to do to progress, start too light as always. Pick a time. We'll lower it in 4 seconds. And each week, try to add a little bit of weight. Do that for 4 weeks. Take a break from it. And then start again with a little bit less time. So maybe lower it just 2 or 3 seconds. And then add a little bit more weight. Be patient. You're going to have good results. See you guys next time.